I mean, I do have a husband, but he is sick. He's unwell. Well, he's dead. And you can't get more sick than dead, can you, ladies? Well, actually, you can, if you've got man flu. Now, to begin with, Samlesbury Hall never used to be here. Madam, you look slightly confused. Or maybe that's just your face. I think it's just a face, yes. Originally, it was built on the banks of the River Ribble. But what happened is the Scots came. Right, we're going to do that again. What happened is the Scots came.
Boom!
Dirty Scots. Are any of you Scottish? Are you Scottish?
Yes.
Dirty Scots! They came, they pulled the original house down to the ground, they booted it about, setting fire to it for sheer delight, because that's the Scottish for you. Anger issues. All that flapping tartan and cold winds, and you don't want two legs there, do you? You rub some butter on it. So in 1325, they rebuilt the house here to celebrate the marriage of Gilbert de Southworth, and I believe the de was for, I don't know, Derek, I've no idea, and his bonny bride, Alice. Now, madam, I can tell by your slightly stunned expression. You're not used to such splendour in a dining hall. Does your dining hall look like this where you are from? No. And where are you from? Oh. Well, I would be lying to you if I said the house was always as grand as you see it now. For when it was first built, it was nothing but a barn. And you'll know all about barns coming from Wolverhampton. She was possibly born in a barn, but I'm not here to judge. You would have been stood on dry earth with straw and reed scattered to soften it underfoot. There were no windows whatsoever. The only light would come from an open fire in the middle of the room, and the smoke would have gone up and out of a crude hole in the thatch above. And that, good people, was that. Now, I know what you're thinking, madam. You're thinking, oh, Janie, what a hovel. And I confess it would not have done for the likes of you, most genteel. However, compared to the peasants that roam the forest out there, dirty peasants, the people who did live here in days of old, they lived like kings. They were warm, they were dry, and they were well fed. But life was rather smelly. You see, the smoke from the open fire, it should have gone up and out of a crude hole above, but on a day like today with rain in the air, the smoke would linger in the room. It would layer like fog. And you could see it, and you could taste it, and you would breathe it in. And you would cough it up. Your spittle, your phlegm that gathered at the corners of your mouths, it would be as grey as the smoke you inhaled. And the sticky eye juice collecting in the corners of your eyes, equally just as grey, until eventually, regardless of age, your skin would turn just as grey. The candles they burned were made of tallow, which is animal fat, so you would get your beast, you would run the bugger through, and the meat would go to your belly, and rightly so. Oh, unless you're one of them vegans. Wasteless spaces. But the fat from the carcass would be cooked down until it formed a sticky tar. Poured into a mould, when dry, that was your candle. And they worked tolerably well, until you lit them. The very second the flame came in contact with the animal fat, it spluttered, it fizzled, and it animal fat. My good woman, you'd have been gipping. You know what I'm saying? He had a great problem with rats. Hundreds of rats coming into the barn looking for food and warmth. They would climb the beams. They would be in the thatch above your heads. Now, I do not know if you are aware, but rats are incontinent. So imagine this fair maiden here.
Hello, fair maiden.
Imagine her sat around the open fire at night, scratching her chilblains. On her head she might feel. And looking up into the thatch roof above, she would see the backside of a rat that had just opened its bowels upon her. The vile stench of rat urine and feces. And the rats would eat the tallow candles. I tell you, sir, it was crazy. I know if you go to some historical houses, they have the beds with the canopies. That's not just there to look pretty. That's to stop the drop-ins landing on them as they slept. Because above their heads, there was no ceiling. There was no plaster. It was just pure thatch and all that lived in it. At night, the family would bring their animals into the barn. They would sleep with their animals, their prize stock, their best beasts, because to leave their animals out there is just asking for the dirty peasants to steal them. Madam, do you have dirty peasants where you are from?
No.
Yeah, and where is it you're from again? Oh, you're Madge. This is Madge. Hello, sir.
How are you?
They're a bit foreign, these ones. I'm doing the best I can. Portsmouth, Bournemouth.
Oh, God. Soft southerners.
Although, they're struggling with our weather. They've been here a few days.
They don't have weather down there.
Well, we're a bit clayey here, and the water has nowhere to go. They're not used to flooding.
It rolls off the hills into the rivers and the sea.
To where they are, yeah. Lands on their heads.
Yeah.
This gentleman's taking the public tour, so as fast as we're going to be going from room to room, he's going to
be chasing you. I have forever been chasing you. The fact that we're 100 years apart has nothing to do with it.
You need to learn to run faster, sir. I'm a witch, I can fairly move.
I know. The only trouble is, what do we do when I catch you?
Set me on fire.
On that note,
and there's his wife smiling through a grimace. Now, ladies and gentlemen, among all the things I have been discussing with you that did smell in days of old, there is something I have not yet mentioned. Does anybody know what it was that did smell by far the worst? People. Well, not you per se, sir. No, all of you smelly buggers. They did not wash. You could go from cradle through to grave without washing once. They believed by exposing their skin to water and air, it's just asking for a fever to grip hold of you and drag you to your grave whether your time was up or not. They did not trust the water to drink, nor did they trust it to bathe. Now, ladies and gentlemen, using your brains, transport yourself forward. The year is now 1530,